Hello friends, welcome to our channel Slide Hunt. Today in this tutorial I am going to teach you arrays in data structure. Data structures are mainly used to store and organize data in efficient way. There are different data structures available, but we start with the simplest one, it's called linear array. So first we know what are arrays. Array is a linear data structure in which homogeneous elements are stored in contiguous memory location. Linear data structure means elements stored in a sequence or in other words form a linear list. Another thing is array stores similar types of elements. For example, here we take an array A which stores 5 integer values. So we can say A is an integer array. And here we can store a float or character value. Because arrays store only homogeneous elements, means similar types of element. Similarly, here we take another array which store only float values. Here we can store integer or character values. The next thing that we learn is called index set. If a linear array has n elements, then elements of linear array are referenced respectively by a set of n consecutive numbers called index set. Smallest index is called lower bound and largest index is called upper bound. For example, here we take an array A which has 5 elements and all the elements are stored in successive memory location. First element of array A is denoted by A of 0. Second element is denoted by A of 1, third element is denoted by A of 2, and this procedure is continue. As we start from 0, so the last element of the array is denoted by A of size minus 1. For this case, size is 5, so the last element will be denoted by A of 5 minus 1, that is A of 4. A of 0 equal to 5, A of 1 equal to 3, A of 2 equal to 1, A of 3 equal to 6 and A of 4 equal to 8. The next thing that we learn is size or length of the array. The number of elements in an array is called the size or length of that array. We can find the length of an array using this formula. Length equal to upper bound minus lower bound plus 1. Let us see an example. Here we take an array A. Lower bound of array A is 0 and upper bound is 4. So the length of A is 4 minus 0 plus 1, that is equal to 5. Let's see another example. Here we take another array B. The lower bound of B is 3 and upper bound is 9. So the length of B is 9 minus 3 plus 1, that is 7. Means B has 7 elements. Next we see what operations are performed on array. First one is insertion. Insertion means adding a new element to the array. Next is deletion. Deletion means remove an element from the list. Third is traversal. Traversal means processing each element in the list. Fourth is search. Searching means find the location of an element with a given value. Fifth is sorting. Sorting means arranging the element in a sequence. It may be ascending order or descending order. And the last one is merging. Merging means combining two lists into a single list. That's it. Hope you understand. If you have any doubt, please comment on the video. Next tutorial, we learn how to insert an element in an array. Thanks for watching. To watch more videos, please subscribe this channel Slide Hunt. You can like my Facebook page at www.facebook.com/slidehunt and you can follow me on Google Plus at www.google.com/plus/slidehunt.